kick by Robertson. And he's going to lead Dallas up. Over the line it goes with Hintz. Pounded away by Ekholm. Ethan Hopkins couldn't get it out. Hintz to Sagan. Knocked off his stick to Robertson. Cycles it down for Hintz. Back it goes, scores! Jason Robertson's on the board. And so are the Dallas Stars.
Well, you mentioned the addition of Roope Hintz. You hope maybe would be a spark for Robertson. We didn't see much at all in the first period, but here's another example of keeping the puck alive. It looked like the Edmonton Oilers were going to clear the zone right on the line, and it's Hintz who keeps it. Two passes later, just walking into it. A little cycle from behind, a good play by Roope Hintz, and then right into the wheelhouse. You saw the reaction of Skinner. He wasn't able to pick up that puck. McDavid a little late on the trail, and Robertson, you talk a looking skyward there, a little bit of relief. 10 games is just an eternity at playoff time for a goal scorer like that, and he gets his first in 11.
His goal tonight, flipped down, and Harley skates back to get it for Dallas with Hyman in slipstream. Up ahead it goes, and a lead feed as Sagan nearly cut in, following up though is Robertson again. Who's looking through? Skinner, another stop, scores! And Dallas has tied it. So the McDavid line in the first period, but the big line for the Stars has struck twice, and it's Jason Robertson once again.
It's just amazing as a player when you just seem like nothing's going right for you. Robertson's been frustrated, hasn't been able to get anything going offensively around the net, and then you score a goal early in the period, you get from behind, and just a little flip up and over. Twice it looked like Skinner was going to be able to get it. Once there, and then on the second shot it pops out, and how about this? Just a backhand fade away as he's able to just get this knuckleball up and over the arm of Stuart Skinner with five Edmonton Oilers all in the vicinity.